In a world where things are getting more expensive by the second, it's easy to feel trapped in the rat race. But I think what's even more sinister is falling into money traps that you don't even know you're stuck in. In this video, we're gonna break down the 5 most common money pitfalls and how you can avoid them, so go ahead and hit the like button and let's get started. The first big money trap is not having an emergency fund. 56% of Americans can't afford a $1,000 emergency expense without digging into their personal savings. And that's pretty scary, because without a financial safety net, you might have to take on debt or fall into financial hardship when an unexpected expense comes into play, or worse, you lose your job. It's like that saying, life is what happens when we're busy making plans, right? So it's really important to have an emergency fund that can rescue you when the plans aren't planning. For your emergency fund, the first thing you want to ask yourself is, how long do I think it'll take me to find another job if I lose my current one? Whatever that amount of time is, whether it's 3 months or 6 months, whatever, that is the amount of living expenses that you want to set aside in your emergency fund. And the best place to keep this money is inside a high yield savings account so that you can earn the most amount of interest possible. The next big money trap is constantly trying to keep up with the Joneses. There is truly nothing good that comes from trying to impress people you don't even like with stuff you don't even want. Because the crazy truth is, most people can't even afford the stuff they have anyway. They might have rich parents that are handing them lots of money, or they're just barely getting by each month and not having any money left over to put into savings and investments. I think this is especially relevant right now with the housing market, because a lot of people feel bad that they can't afford these massive down payments on a house, when in reality, a lot of times their friends are getting money from their parents to buy a house. And of course, your friends or your acquaintances, and especially people you don't really know all that well, aren't out there shouting this from the rooftops. They don't want everyone to hate them for having this major advantage. They want everyone to think that they've worked really hard for it and that they've got it all figured out. And that's the thing about trying to keep the pace with somebody else's lifestyle. It's not just the money. It's a psychological and a social thing. And it can make you stressed and anxious and take you up to your eyeballs in debt. These wealth performances, if you will, don't actually tell you how the person got them in the first place, and it can warp our perception of what is financially doable and normal for most people. The more you focus on your own financial journey and avoid getting tangled up in what everyone else is doing, the faster you'll start to build real wealth instead of just creating some elaborate illusion. Which leads me to the next big money trap: feeling like you have to buy a house as soon as possible. Every time I say this, people freak out because they're like, but Jazz, why would you waste money on rent? Owning a home is the only way. But you have to move past the real estate is king gospel of the last 50 years and understand that right now, in the present, owning is not always the most financially responsible decision. The majority of housing in America right now is more expensive to own than it is to rent. And beyond the most basic cost of securing a mortgage, owning a home is a lot more than that. It's the property taxes in escrow. It's the cost of maintenance and upkeep. It's the interest on the loan. If you were to take the money that you save by renting and invest it into the stock market, you may very well come out ahead of someone who bought a house at the same time, depending on the circumstances. Now, a lot of this is going to depend on where you live, so do yourself a favor and plug your numbers into a rent versus buy calculator. In certain areas of the country, like California, there are very real scenarios where you would never come out ahead buying, and you would accumulate substantially more wealth by renting and investing the difference. My point is, don't rush to buy a house just because society says that homeownership is the financially responsible thing to do. Before you sit down and spend $30,000 over asking and waive inspections, just please sit down and run the numbers and make sure that for your scenario, buying a house actually makes any sense at all. The next financial pitfall is buying a brand new car.
The minute you drive the car off the lot, it starts losing value.
And depending on the type of car, it can drop 20 to 30% of the price you paid in the first year.
The problem with all of this is by the time you figure out you can't afford those hefty monthly payments, you might already be underwater on your car loan, which means you owe more on the loan than what the car is actually worth. So you think, no problem, I'll just trade it back to the dealership.
But guess what? Your car's value dropped the moment you drove away.
So it's now worth less than what you owe on it. So even if you trade the car in at this point, you would still be in debt. This cycle of new car loans is seriously so vicious, and it's honestly really sad to see how many young people get sucked into it. The bottom line is there are plenty of ways to get from point A to point B without totally breaking the bank.
And I'll admit, the last couple of years were totally weird, where used car prices and new car prices were pretty similar.
But things are finally getting back to normal. Generally speaking, you are much better off buying a certified pre-owned car and getting your own financing from your bank as opposed to the car dealership. You'll get a much better price that way, a way better interest rate, and if you time it right, you might be able to sell your used car for not that much less than what you bought it for.
And last but not least, one of the biggest money traps of all is not taking advantage of time. When you're young, you have so much time ahead of you to let your money get to work. The concept of compound interest, where you earn interest on the money you've invested, but also on the interest you've accumulated, works best over long periods of time. This is why investing at a young age is so beneficial, because the more money you put away while you're young, the more time your money has to grow. But because people don't understand how compound interest works or what it does, many people put off investing until they're much older. In fact, lots of people don't even set up their retirement accounts at work. If you start investing $250 a month in your early 20s, by the time you retire at 65, you'll have $1.3 million. But if you wait until your 30s to start investing the same amount, you'll only have $500,000. And if you wait until your 40s, you'll only have $200,000. So investing any amount of money as early as possible is the fastest and most efficient way to build wealth. Retirement might feel like a long ways away now, but trust me, when you get there, you will be so glad that you started investing sooner rather than later. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for being here. Smash the like button, and I'll see you in the next one.